Hey guys, Sandeep here. Today we are going to solve a practical problem using DFS.
Contact tracing using DFS. Assume the local authority asked us to build a contact tracing server for COVID-19. This will help them marking area as red zone, orange zone and green zone. Red zone is where highly infected people lives. Orange zone is moderately infected and green zone is safe zone. Now, it boils down to some functionality in the server which will return the max number of infected people who lives very close to each other in a certain region, right? So how do we do this? Let's mark infected people as 1 and non-infected as 0. Put this data for a region into a geological two-dimensional matrix. Now count the max connected ones and return it. Once we have this data, we can mark the region as red, orange or green zone. I have pulled a lead code problem. Watch this. Max area of island. Find the maximum area of an island in the given 2D array. If there is no island, the maximum area is 0. So it's very analogous to the problem that we have discussed so far. Clearly, what we have to do here, we have to just count the ones which are connected to each other, right? And we have to return the max count in this given array, right? We can clearly use DFS approach here to solve this problem. What we will do, while traversing the cells, if the value is 1, we will look at all our neighbors, okay, all our friends. If they are 1, we will count them also, right? And finally, the maximum value we will return, okay? Okay, fine, let's solve this problem. If grid is null or grid dot length equal to 0, then return 0. Okay, good. Now what? We'll start a for loop. Int I equal to 0, I less than grid dot length I plus plus. Another for loop for the columns, int j equal to 0, j less than grid I length j plus plus. Now right here we'll call our DFS method, okay? So DFS, okay, what are we going to pass here? We're going to pass the grid and the index, the row and the column value. Fine. So the idea here for this DFS method is actually to return the size of the cluster, the size of a particular area, okay? And then we will find the, we'll just like, you know, in the for loop, we'll continue finding the max value. So now max will be what? Max is math dot max of max and the whatever the DFS method will return us, right? And then return max. Right, yeah, let's initialize this max with integer dot min value. Okay, yeah, good. So now let's write the DFS method. Int DFS int grid two-dimensional array int I int j, so row and column, row and columns. Yeah, now in DFS three steps, right? First is validation. Let's do the validation first. Okay, so let's validation. Okay, so what do you want to do here? Sorry, grid, this can also be our base case. So yeah, if, what do you want to do here? Yeah, if I is less than 0 or I is greater than equal to grid's length, one case, or j is less than 0 or j is greater than equal to grid I length, right? Then return 0. If grid of I and j equal to 0, then also we want to return 0, right? Okay, good. Now next step is what? Next step is processing, right? Okay. In this step, we want to consider the current cell as one count, okay? So int count equal to 1, okay? We don't want to double count this cell because we have already counted, right? In DFS, as we know, we are going to call the same method again, so we might double count. So to avoid that, either you have to use a set or hash map. The beauty about having this matrix, this binary matrix, is we can actually flip 1 to 0 and we can still say that, okay, we have seen this cell already, we have visited this cell already. So yeah, let's do that. Grid I j equal to 0. So visited, or we can say processed, or stop double counting, right? Okay, good. Now the third step. Third step is what? So push the neighboring cells to this stack, right? That's what we will do. Or call DFS method for 4 of its connected cells, right? That's what we will do, right? Yeah, see, we are not considering the diagonal elements here, okay? Now we want to accumulate the counts. Let's do this. Count plus equal to DFS grid I plus 1 j, okay? So, which is our east side, okay? Now, copy this 4 times, yep. And now, this would be west. West is our what? I minus 1, okay? This should be our north, okay? North is j minus 1, okay? And south, south is our j plus 1, right? Yeah, so we called 4 times for all these 4 cells that we are looking at. And then return count. Let me run the code. Okay, yeah, there is a semicolon missing. Let's see. Yep, this is good. Okay. Cool, accepted. Fine. And then submit. Wow, nice. You see this? Runtime 2 milliseconds faster than 99.42. Yep. Yep. So that's good. What's the time complexity here? It is O of total number of cell, actually, right? Total number of cell is nothing but N into M, where N is number of rows and M is number of columns. Okay. And space complexity is also O of N into M because of the call stack.
So we saw how these data structures can be used in practical applications. If you like this content, like, share, subscribe and comment below.